Hello, welcome to DJI Academy. I'm Lin, a drone pilot and part of DJI's product training team. So today, I'm going to talk to you about DJI's latest product, the Mavic 3 Enterprise. There is a lot of new features to talk about, but the biggest question to most of us is why it is important to us. So in this video, I will cover the pros and cons of this new model compared to its predecessors, the Mavic 2 Enterprise and Pattern 4 RTK, then do some tests to get a real-world example of the differences. First, let's take a look at the aircraft. So, as you can see, it is almost the same size as Mavic 2 Enterprise. Compared to Mavic 2 Enterprise, it includes omnidirectional obstacle sensing. So, the aircraft could sense objects in all directions and fly more safely. A PSD key port for RTK module and speaker is also included. And there is a built-in beacon to save a port for your other attachments. This drone could use a 100-watt fast charging adapter, and it could be charged by a laptop. That rocks.
What have you done? What the f***?
Besides the hardware, let's dig more into the main difference, the cameras. This new model is equipped with two cameras, the wild and the zoom. So let's see the zoom camera first. The zoom camera offers a 1/2-inch CMOS sensor and 12-megapixel resolution. On the Mavic 2 Enterprise, you can get a 48mm equivalent field of view. On the Mavic 3E, it is possible to get a 162mm equivalent field of view, which is 2 times larger than M2E. Additionally, you can do 8 times digital zoom. So, you can spot the license plate number clearly 100 meters away. Let's talk about the brand new RTK module, which makes the Mavic 3E perfect for mapping and surveying. As you can see, this new module is much smaller and lighter. It is 23 grams, which is 60% lighter than the old version. To take full advantage of the positioning modules, the new TimeSync 2.0 is used to align the flight controller, the camera, and RTK module at microsecond level. It ensures each photo uses the most accurate metadata. You can align the drone data right into your camera with centimeter level accuracy. Besides data accuracy, there is one more thing I care a lot, the efficiency. They both have a wild camera that offers 220 megapixel resolution. But comparing the Mavic 3E to Phantom 4 RTK, the shutter speed of M3E has improved from 2.5 seconds to 0.7, which means it takes less time to finish the flight mission under same resolution and GSD. For example, when both GSD is 2 cm per pixel and the resolution is same, the flight speed of Phantom 4 RTK is 5 meters per second, while the Mavic 3E could reach 15 meters per second, which is 12 faster than the Pattern 4 RTK due to the higher shutter speed. Let's take 2 more tests for its efficiency. Here I have set the GSD, the overlap ratio, the speed, and the flight route altitude to the same values. As you can see, under same flight time, the Mavic 3E can finish a serving area which is 1 times larger than Phantom 4 RTKs. And the Mavic 3 Enterprise can scan a 2 times larger area in one sortie when other parameters are same due to a longer flight time. Mavic 3 Enterprise is like a combination of Mavic 2 Enterprise and Phantom 4 RTK, but better performance. The wide camera provides a 4-sensor CMOS sensor, 20 megapixel resolution, 4K video at 30 frames per second, and its pixel size is increased to 3.3 icons, which brings higher dynamic range and helps record more details in low light conditions. Here is a comparison of two other graphic images taken by Mavic 3 Enterprise and Phantom 4 RTK. As you can see, Mavic 3 Enterprise does a better job reproducing colors and clarifying details. Above all, I would say the Mavic 3 Enterprise is more portable and highly efficient with its great shooting speed and smaller size compared to Phantom 4 RTK, and it offers higher quality images. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I will add more information of the drone's application scenarios in the next review after finishing all tests. Thanks for watching. Please click like and subscribe, and let me know what you think in the comments. I will see you next time.